course.
Was that you?
Yeah.
Motherfucker. What happened? What happened with you? What did he do?
He beat me with the Tupac can, and I shouldn't have went in with a Tupac can because we were at the... It was Brandon's birthday party.
Right. Yeah. What was that, video game?
No, poker.
No, poker.
And, why Tupac? What does that mean?
It was a joke. It's basically I had a pocket fours, right? And I was one of the chip leaders, and he was playing really tight, and he was, you know, he was a small stack. So I shouldn't have played pocket fours, but I got involved with him, and the cameras were involved. I said, I'm gonna play my Tupac.
And you got burned.
4-4, make sure all y'all kids don't grow.
Is poker your game?
I like poker, man. I like poker when I'm off training. You know, you spend a lot of time inside the air conditioning. Get some, you know, you get aggression, you get passiveness, you learn patience.
What about gin? Gin?
What?
Gin?
No.
Solitaire?
None of that, man.
War? Who has a bigger card win?
None of that. Poker. Just because it involves, you know, mentality, a little bit of aggression.
You recently sparred Roberto Duran. What was that experience like for you?
Well, it was accidental. I was just there because Art, this guy was sparring Mosley.
What's up, Art?
This guy's going to be a killer, bro.
So, where's he from?
He's from the gym, man.
No, originally.
Montebello, born and raised, man.
Oh, I thought he was like Armenian.
Oh, he's Armenian.
Oh, okay. So I was wrong. Okay.
Yeah. Actually, Roberto Duran nicknamed him El Arminio. Right?
El Arminio?
Yeah. So we're out there sparring, and then he sparred with him, and then he sparred with me, and then we're like, what the hell's going on? And then Duran was just like, I want to get in there, and he puts on the headgear, he puts on everything. I'm like, is he serious? And he just came in, and he thought he was going to be the Duran of the 70s, but then that thin air hit us. It was different.
He gassed out a little.
No, but Duran is a man, bro. I mean, at 62 years old, I could see what he was doing in there, and it was still tough, man.
I got to ask you this, though. You've been calling out Triple G before it was popular, before anybody even knew Triple G was a big star.
And before he was
the killer
who he is now, yeah.
You're still calling him out?
No. Take that back.
Okay.
No, I just think he's become the headliner now. I think he demands attention now. Back when I would say I would fight him, we're on the same page. Both of us were actually, I was a former champion, and I think he wasn't even a champion yet, or maybe just barely became champion. And I said, I like to, you know, try my hands on him, but no, he's a real deal now. We know he's a real deal now. I'm not calling him
okay,
out anymore.
Okay, there's talk of Danny Jacobs, who you fought twice,
yeah,
against Triple G. Sergio Mora, break it down.
Look, man, Daniel Jacobs is the hardest puncher I've been in the ring with. And I could tell you that when I was in damn great shape the first time, and the second time I was in great shape, but I was, you know, a little idle and my leg wasn't the same, and blah, blah, blah. The dude has the power. If he cracks Golovkin, then we're gonna see how Golovkin acts when he has a little shakiness to him. We've seen him get hit, but we haven't seen him get hurt. Jacobs hurt him, so it's gonna be something where whoever takes each other's punch better, and I think Jacobs probably punches a little harder than Golovkin.
Wow, why do you say that? That's the first guy.
But here's the thing. I think Golovkin has better technique. So with technique, as a rounds pass.